I'm Janet Robin, and today we're going to learn about doing some riffs and licks while utilizing a percussive technique, okay? And this is especially useful on acoustic guitar because, again, once again, acoustic guitar is like a drum, you know, and it's like it got a built-in snare. So we can, you know, take advantage of that. And I think, you know, a really unique style is to throw in some percussive riffs, even if you're just playing like some blues, you know, typical blues riffs or pentatonic riffs. Right? So all I did there was I just went a little bit more heavy on my right hand with the pick, and I utilized some pinching. I also was hitting the strings a little bit more aggressive. You don't necessarily need to be aggressive when you do this, you know, these percussive techniques, but you do want to have kind of a heavy-handed right hand. So I'm not going to show you exactly what it was that I played in the introduction, but I'm going to show you kind of the technique behind it, you know, just utilizing a simple riff. So clean, without the percussive, it's like, totally cool, love it, you know? Now, if you wanna have a little bit more rhythm, you're gonna add a little bit more hits. The first attack is gonna come from up above on the right hand. And here we go with those hits. Okay, so plucking up and hitting the guitar, not slapping it. Okay, we're not doing that. We're literally hitting the guitar, and it's with this side of the palm. Okay, not this side, this side. So don't be afraid to hit the guitar. It's not gonna break. If it breaks, you don't have a good enough guitar. So, right? That's the first thing you wanna try to do. Now, I'm going to utilize something they do in sort of like funk and soul playing. It's like, so I'm also doing finger mutes on the left hand. That's creating some percussive sound too. See, and you get a little bit of a harmonic. It's kind of cool. Now, if you put that together with hits, so what you should do is you should experiment with some of your favorite riffs, and you should try these techniques. Try to apply them, maybe at the end of the phrase, like that, you know. Even just simple, if you want to kind of get used to what it sounds like, you just go. Just to get used to that feeling of banging on the guitar. Right? So you're, every time you're slapping, you're coming up. It's not really a slap, it's more of a hit. So, and you're coming from underneath the string, whatever string it is you choose. Okay, again, once again, I'm utilizing also left hand. Okay, finger mute, left hand. What do I mean by finger mute? Let me explain again. Relieve the pressure. Relieve the pressure. And that's how you get that. And I'm also picking up. So the percussive part of playing, you know, guitar, especially an acoustic, it's not only on the right hand. You know, let's utilize the left hand as well. Thank you. This is a really good one too. Before I was having you do this. I was having you do. Now I'm going to help you with the finger mute. So, hit, don't press, and do the left hand finger mute. Hit, and then come up. So, pluck, hit, and finger mute. Right? That's a really cool exercise. You can apply any kind of rhythm, you know, you can put that finger mute wherever you want. Now, if you're having trouble with the finger mute, then you just want to do this. It doesn't matter really where you put your finger. Just make sure it's over a string. You kind of get a little bit of a harmonic. Okay, so let's go over again those simple exercises. Just first the hit, you can just take like, and you're gonna pluck up. Go back down. Again, be aware of where I'm hitting that, right? I mean, if you hear that, it sounds just like a kick drum, right? With a little bit of a snare. Silence, silence, silence. If you want to practice each string, it really actually wouldn't hurt because it'll get you more comfortable with this technique. And the other thing too is, you know, you have to be aware of when you come down on the hit to make sure you're going to land on whatever string it is you want to land. So if it's on the same string that you've plucked first, you want to make sure you land on that, you know? So, of course, if you're going to land on another string, you want to make sure your right hand is going to nail that string as well. Okay, now the other exercise I want you to practice again with me is just the finger mute. So just put your finger anywhere you want. Let's just put it for now over the sixth string. And we'll just do the sixth string. I'm plucking up underneath the string. Okay, now we're gonna add the hit. Okay, so press, hit, finger mute. Press and strum, hit, finger mute. Press and strum, hit, finger mute. At this point, I'm plucking up and under, okay, for this particular riff. So if you want to try that, okay, so this is a really cool technique. It takes a little bit of time to kind of finesse. Give yourself the time. Work on these little exercises. Break it down. It's a lot about the right hand. Of course, there are some left hand things involved. But give a little bit more time to your right hand. And make sure you're really hitting it over the right place of your hand. It's not a slap. I'm not doing that. I'm doing this. Right over this pad, right, of the hand. And it's not over there. It's over here in between the end of the sound hole and the bridge. you're going to get a really nice boomy sound, especially when the acoustic guitar has a pickup and it's going through a sound system. It's going to be like boom, and it's really super cool. Something you can't totally get on an electric guitar. All right, so again, my name is Janet Robin. I hope you enjoyed this little mini video guitar lesson on how to do some percussive guitar riffs, and practice hard, be safe and sound, and I'll see you next time.